My name is Mila Burns. I'm a professor at CUNY, at Lehman College, and here at the Graduate Center. I'm also the Associate Director of the Center for Latin American, Caribbean, and Latino Studies. We call it CLECOS. And we are wherever you are in terms of social media, Facebook, X, is that how we call it? We're there too. Instagram, so please follow us. We are a center that supports Latino and Latin American students here at the Graduate Center. I was one of these students, and I really benefited from the support of the CLECOS here. And the Graduate Center is a house in the heart of Manhattan that really welcomes people from all over the world. So we really appreciate you being here today, and keep tuned to see what we have going on. All events are free and open to the public. Thank you so much for being here tonight, and I hope we have a great night of conversation and music. Now, Alex.
Well, I'm Alex. I work at the Brazilian Consulate. Most of you guys know me from there. But also, I have online web radio because I love music. And I am thrilled today to have here one of, in my opinion, one of the greatest new artists on the MPB, the Brazilian music. The first song that I heard from her, I heard one time, and I just felt in love with the lyrics, with the passion that she sings. And I thought to myself, I said, I want her here in New York. Mm-hmm. And guess what? It happens. Mm-hmm. Tonight, we're gonna have here Roberta Campos. Let's hear for her.
Hello, hello, yeah.
Oi.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much, Roberta, for being here. Again, thank you all. We're gonna try to conduct this conversation in both English and Portuguese. So we're gonna be asking the questions in English and translating them briefly, and then Roberta will be replying in Portuguese, and I'll be trying to translate, so I'm so sorry in advance if I take too long or if I forget a few words, and I count on your help for that. So, Roberta, I would like us to begin by talking a little bit about your childhood, because it's not a typical one. We think of Brazilians, especially maybe, but not necessarily, but musicians as people who are coming sometimes from families where there are professional musicians nearby, or people who start at school and then fall for it, and your start in music was different from all of that. Roberta comes from a very small city in Minas Gerais, in the state of Minas Gerais in Brazil, and Caetanópolis. And which happens to be small, but has produced not only one, but two amazing musicians from Brazil. Clara Nunes is also from Caetanópolis. And there's a wall actually in the city with the both of them, with the image of both of them. And Roberta, when she was 11, her parents got divorced. And that was the moment when she went to live with her grandparents, and someone in the family gave the great idea of asking a neighbor to practice so that she could get distracted and not as saddened by the divorce of her parents. So music came up in your life as a solution for sadness, as something that was deeply connected to emotions, to love and heartbreak. Can you tell us a little bit how that start has impacted your life and your connection with music, and especially your compositions that are so deeply connected with love and with feelings and with emotions? Você pode falar um pouquinho pra gente qual é a conexão entre a sua infância e você ter começado a carreira musical mesmo aos 11, de certa forma, ligada ao divórcio dos seus pais, com a emoção que você transmite nas suas canções, inclusive nas suas composições até hoje?
Claro. Quando eu comecei a gostar de música, assim, na verdade, eu não tenho uma lembrança muito clara, mas eu tenho a lembrança de que sempre foi uma paixão para mim.
I don't quite remember how it felt when I started playing music, but I do remember that it's always been a passion for me.
E aos 9 anos, eu lembro de ver na casa da minha avó frequente assim um violão. E eu queria muito aprender a tocar aquele instrumento, E eu antes eu achava que eu até sabia até pegar o instrumento e não sair nada assim.
When I was nine, I used to see a guitar there lying there in my grandmother's house, and I actually thought I knew how to play it until the day I really decided to hold it and realized that I didn't know how to play it at all.
E sempre foi muito claro que eu amava música, né? Todo mundo sabia, meus familiares. E quando meus pais separaram, eu fui invadida, assim, para uma criança de 11 anos, não tinha muita noção de como tratar aquela dor, assim, né? Minha mãe foi embora, fui morar com os meus avós. E a minha tia, acho que ela teve uma sensibilidade muito grande e me convidou a ir na casa de vizinho que tocava violão para ele me ensinar alguns acordes.
Everybody knew I liked music, but I didn't quite know the impact of that, and as an 11-year-old having to face the divorce of my parents, I really didn't know how to put together and get a hold of my emotions at that time. So fortunately, this aunt suggested that I get to know this neighbor and finally approach music in a different way.
E para mim abriu portal muito grande, que eu já amava muito a música e eu me vi ali naquele momento com a chave de curar a minha vida, né? Então a música sempre foi uma coisa que eu usei, assim, eu digo que a música é um sentimento que eu uso sempre para um remédio, né, para curar qualquer problema que eu tenho, não só para celebrar momentos felizes, mas como um instrumento de cura também.
For me it felt as if a portal had opened, and music has been for me since then not only something to celebrate but also something that felt like medicine. Felt like something that I could use to cure myself and to cure things in the world.
E eu sempre tive muito amor, né? Não só pela música, mas pelas pessoas. E além desse amor que eu sentia, que eu acredito muito que a gente nutre um sentimento não de fora para dentro, mas de dentro para fora. Então a música só me ajudou a externar esse amor, e por isso eu gosto tanto de cantar o amor nas minhas canções e cantar coisas bonitas também.
I love not only music, but I love people. And I always felt that music was what gave me the possibility of really showing these feelings, not from the outside to inside, but from inside out. That's why I have so much love for people, that I feel like my songs have this love too, and they transmit, they show this love. And I like to sing beautiful things too. So, Roberta, actually, there is one of the songs that I think it was one of the first songs that you learned how to play, or maybe the first one, with this neighbor of yours, called Casinha Branca, que foi uma das primeiras músicas que você aprendeu a tocar. And when you were recording your first album, you were almost done there, and you felt like there was a missing piece in that puzzle. And then you included that song, which is part of Brazilian, like, traditional song, I dare say. Can you tell us a little bit about your relationship with that song and maybe play a little bit for us? Você pode falar um pouquinho pra gente da sua relação com Casinha Branca e de repente contar, tocar um pouquinho pra gente?
Quando eu tinha uns 5 anos de idade, eu vi pela primeira vez alguém tocar violão e cantar uma canção, e era essa música, e era o meu tio, avô, irmão da minha avó, que estava cantando, e tem uma recordação de ir atrás desse som, assim, e ficar muito impactada. É uma coisa muito forte que às vezes eu busco na memória, eu chego a sentir aquela emoção que me tomou.
That's so beautiful. I still remember that song as the first song I ever heard someone playing live, and it was my mother's great uncle, who was playing it for me. And I remember seeing him play and feeling that it was the most beautiful thing. And I still remember when I play that song, it feels like I travel to that moment, and I still feel those feelings and those memories come back and overwhelm me somehow. So let's hear Casinha Branca.
Cada vez mais longe a felicidade.
in Minas Gerais. Roberta is a mineira too. Tiago is a mineiro. So how many more mineiros do we have here from Minas Gerais? Look, we have the house full of mineiros.
Vitória conta? No. Vitória conta? No.
We put it. Yeah. She's mineiro. Everybody here now is a mineiro. That's it. Roberta, when you start, did you thought right in the beginning where you want to be, or you just want to play for fun, or you said, I want to be playing New York, because you have a show coming up in 2 days. So I want to know, what was your goal back then, if you saw yourself here, right after the Casinha Branca? Esqueci o português.
Então, a primeira memória que eu tenho quando eu comecei a tocar violão assim, foi de ver as pessoas me assistindo.
My first memories of playing were actually of seeing people watching me and seeing me play.
E às vezes eu fazia muito sozinha assim, essas coisas, né? Eu tinha um sonho muito grande, mas sempre sonhava muito sozinha e ficava viajando. Por exemplo, a minha rua era muito vazia. E eu pegava um banco, colocava assim no meio da rua, não passava carro nem nada, e fechava o olho e imaginava que eu estava tocando para um monte de gente.
My first dreams about playing are very, very remote, and I kept thinking about that by my own frequently, and sometimes I would project myself in situations like the street I used to live on. It was a very silent one, very small, in a small city, so I would imagine myself sitting in the middle of the street and playing for a huge audience.
E depois eu fui, os sonhos foram aumentando à medida que eu ia crescendo, né?
And little by little the dreams became bigger.
Porque antes eu não tinha muita clareza do que eu queria fazer. Eu só sabia que a música me fazia bem. Só que depois eu fui entendendo que poderia ser algo maior e de fato foi se tornando cada vez que eu fui buscando, entendendo, querendo, foi se tornando algo bem maior.
In the beginning I didn't quite know what I wanted to do with that. I just knew that music made me feel well. It made good to me. And I kept playing and playing until eventually I realized what it could really mean.
E algo muito rápido aconteceu, que com 13 anos eu entendi que eu podia compor também. Eu vi uma amiga comentou que um menino da classe dela compunha e tinha um caderno com 80 músicas.
And when I was 13, actually, I realized that I could also write music. A friend of mine at school told me that she knew this boy, and he had a little notebook with 80 songs.
E eu fiquei muito curiosa.
And he's very curious about
that. E fiquei, 80 músicas? Como assim? Sim, ele compõe, ele que fez.
Yeah, and I said, what, 80 songs? How do you mean? Yeah, he wrote them, he made them.
Aí ela disse, eu vou pedir para ele te mostrar se ele tiver levado o caderno e violão amanhã. Passa lá na minha classe.
And then she said, I'm gonna ask him to show that to you. If he brings his notebook and his guitar, I'll tell him to stop by at your class or you stop by at our classroom. That sounds so much, sorry for that, but like John and Paul McCartney. Doesn't it? Like them at school, right?
Parece muito essas memórias que vocês falam, eu vou levar. Você faz música, pode escrever, muito lindo.
I know you're a big Beatle fan, so yeah.
Então, ele me mostrou essa música e eu olhei ele tocando assim, uma canção, aí eu olhei o caderno, pode ver, não sei o quê. E eu disse, eu vou fazer isso também.
Wow. So I looked at his notebook, I looked at him playing his own songs, and I was like, I'm gonna do that.
E o Alex falou sobre a Casinha Branca, né? Ele tinha até me perguntado mais cedo o que eu imaginava quanto a essa música. Eu acho que ela é a construção, assim, ou a reconstrução da minha vida, se eu posso dizer assim. Por mais que seja uma canção triste, ela tem um desejo muito feliz, né? Uma coisa muito forte de a casinha branca, com o quintal, a janela, ou seja, para você plantar e colher frutos e ver o sol nascer.
So Alex had asked me before what I thought about this song, what my Casinha Branca was. Casinha Branca means little white house, so what it meant to me.
And actually for me it means somehow building or constructing something, or actually reconstructing something, because it has this feeling of desire, of wishing, of expecting something. And for me, I feel like this place of expectation, this place of longing is very connected to the song.
E a música, ela, em todos os sentidos, assim, foi uma perspectiva de vida que eu tive, porque a minha cidade, como você falou, é uma cidade muito pequena. Eu nasci numa cidade de 10 mil habitantes e morava na cidade grande, tinha 20 mil habitantes.
She's saying that this song really brings that to her because, as we said before, she was born in a very small city. She was actually born in a city of 10,000 people, and actually then she moved to the big city with 20,000.
Como foi difícil para Clara Nunes, né, que nasceu lá também, assim, há décadas antes de mim, mas também foi muito difícil para ela, também foi difícil para mim, que ambas também, a gente tem muita coisa parecida. Nascemos na mesma cidade e também tivemos... A cidade é uma cidade pobre, mas a nossa família era uma família muito pobre também.
Yeah, and I feel like this is a challenge that is ongoing somehow, because Clara Nunes, whom we mentioned before, was a gigantic, a very, very amazing Brazilian singer, was born in the same city. And it's not only a very poor city, but they were from very poor families in a poor city. So this is very challenging, and it was challenging for Clara Nunes decades earlier, and it continued to be challenging for her.
Então a nossa música nasceu de muita perseverança e amor por aquilo que a gente queria fazer. E para mim, eu construí cada coisa que eu sabia que poderia me ajudar nessa caminhada para chegar até aqui.
So our music, for the both of us, for myself and for Clara Nunes, came from this really desire and perseverance and love for what we really wanted to do and wanted to achieve. Maravilha. Alex, você quer fazer aquela pergunta que você mencionou mais cedo? Você estava conversando e você mencionou aquela questão dos desafios, né?
Yes, I want to make that question, but I was thinking here, you know, after hearing her saying that, I think I want to change my profession. I want to write music.
I'm so sorry, Alex.
But this is the thing. I have a problem. I don't sing well. I don't know how to write. Yeah. I want to ask her later how to do that.
She talked about desire, and you feel like it's just a matter of desiring. I'm going to be me.
I don't know, Roberta. How easy it is to write songs? How easy it is to make a record and all that stuff? How do I do it? I have a tape recorder at home.
O Alex está dizendo que, ouvindo você falar tudo isso, ele ficou inspirado e agora ele quer seguir a carreira musical.
Ah.
Então ele está perguntando para você, ela é tão generosa, né? Você é tão generosa. Como é que é o processo? Como é que se compõe? De onde saem as músicas? E como é que ele faz para seguir essa carreira?
Eu, quando falei lá atrás sobre ver aquele menino que tinha um caderno de músicas, eu fui entender como se construía uma canção, por exemplo, de um grupo, observar canções que eu gostava. Tinha um grupo que eu ouvia muito, que era o Kid Abelha, então eu aprendi ali a estrutura da música.
When I saw this kid with a notebook, I realized that I needed to understand the structure and the process of making music, and I started paying attention to that when I heard songs of groups and singers that I liked at the time. One of those was Kid Abelha, which was a very prominent Brazilian rock band in the 80s, and she would hear and listen to them and understand that as a process and how she could develop something similar.
Aí eu tirava as músicas e também fui observando como eles formavam ali o campo harmônico daquelas canções.
So I started playing by ear, and little by little was understanding how they formed the structure of the song with the chords and everything, and how they created a harmony and a melody that made sense.
E eu tive muita sorte, assim, de ser sempre muito curiosa e ouvir muita música. Então eu ouvia rádio o dia inteiro. Não tinha muito recurso, assim, de comprar discos e tudo, mas sempre o rádio foi um grande companheiro e um grande aprendizado também.
I've been fortunate for have always been very, very curious. So I kept listening to music on the radio every single day, all the time. I didn't have the resources to buy albums, but I would listen to the radio all the time and pay attention to everything.
E aí, quando você escuta muita coisa, você acaba tendo também mais criatividade. Que eu acredito que essa criatividade a gente sempre tem que ficar dando informações, trazendo... Você a inspiração, né, é muita vivência. Então, quanto mais eu escutava aquelas canções, eu fui criando um banco de dados aqui de criatividades melódicas também.
So the more I would listen to a song, the more I feel like I created somehow an HD in my brain with references and melodies and things like that that would help me out when I started developing my own songs and my own creations.
E sobre as minhas letras, eu sempre gostei de falar das coisas que eu vivo, elas nascem do meu coração mesmo. Então o que eu sinto, eu falo na minha música.
And my lyrics are always about what I feel, what I live in my life. So whatever I'm going through, that is reflected in my songs. I write that in my songs.
Já falei muito também sobre coisas que meio que pensando para frente, coisas que às vezes eu não estava vivendo naquele momento, mas eu gostaria muito de viver.
I also sometimes write about, and I did that quite often at some point, about things that I would like to live, the dreams, the things that I longed for, and sometimes that is also part of what I write about. Okay, beautiful. And since you're talking about your process of composing songs, can you tell us a little bit about, actually you're telling about two things, so I'm not sure, I think maybe when you say that you were little and listening to the radio and just breaking songs apart, I don't know if you all are familiar, but Roberta has a podcast, a tiny, I don't even know if there's a name for that, like microcast or something like that, because it's like 2 minute long, sometimes three, sometimes one, in which she looks at one song and really like tells the story about the song and what is going on there, one track. It's called Multiversos, and I strongly recommend that you check it out wherever you listen to your podcasts. And there are many fascinating ones, but next week here, the Clecos is having another event connected to Brazilian music. It's a book launch with Márcio Borges, and it's a book about Clube da Esquina, which is was considered actually last year to be the best album of all time in Brazil. It's September 14th, in case you're wondering, also free and open to the public. So Roberta, can you tell us a little bit about the podcast project, about your, if you continue to do that, looking every song you listen and try to do the same process, did it become something naturalized? And can you tell us a little bit about your version of Márcio Borges' song, and maybe, I don't know, play it for us and how you analyzed it in the podcast? Você pode contar pra gente um pouquinho do podcast, dizer se esse podcast, de certa forma, é reflexo disso que você contou, você continua tendo esse hábito de ouvir uma música e desmembrar a música, não só a história, a letra, mas a harmonia também, como você faz nos podcasts?
Então, esse podcast surgiu com a vontade de falar de composição, né? E de, na verdade, em arte no geral, assim, sobre compositores, arranjadores, produtores e tudo.
So this podcast came up because I really wanted to talk about songwriting, about compositions, about authors, about the process of creating a song.
E eu sempre fui fascinada por esse outro lado, né, acho que é a parte principal, né, onde e como surgem as canções. E comecei a pesquisar sobre a história delas.
So I've always been fascinated about that. How is a song born? How do they come to existence? So I started researching about the history in each song.
E é uma coisa que eu sempre tive curiosidade, isso acompanha a minha vida, sempre gosto muito de pesquisar sobre essas coisas, então juntei o útil, o prazer, né, com essa vontade também de publicar e compartilhar com o público essas minhas pesquisas.
This is part of my life. It's like something that I'm always doing that. I'm always looking for more information on every song I listen to. I also always want to know more. So it was creating the podcast became something like using something that I love to do to also make it useful for other people and just be generous to share with everyone my findings, my researches.
E o mais legal é que eu sempre venho me surpreendendo também. Sempre me surpreendo mesmo passado tanto tempo assim. Que eu sempre pesquisei, né? Mas só que à medida que eu vou mergulhando, e às vezes sei de uma história, mas eu vou mais a fundo, eu fico mais surpresa e mais apaixonada.
And I've always done my research, but it feels sometimes like, even if I already like a song, the more I know about it, the deeper my love grows for that song. So it's a process.
E o mais engraçado é que às vezes eu já conhecia um pouco de uma música, ou às vezes não conhecia, Mas a gente acaba escutando a canção de uma outra forma quando você sabe da história dela.
Yeah, sometimes even if you like the song or you know a little bit about that, once you know what is behind the song, you start listening to it in a different way. So I really like to do that.
E às vezes conto um pouquinho sobre as minhas composições também.
And sometimes in the podcast I not only talk about songs created by other writers, but also my own songs. So maybe can we listen to Quem Sabe Esquece de Amor? Play? Yeah?
Antes de cantar, eu queria contar que eu estive junto do Márcio Borges, né, com a Cris Fuscaldo, no lançamento desse livro, que é maravilhoso, em comemoração aos 50 anos do Clube da Esquina. E tive o prazer, assim, fiquei super emocionada de poder cantar essa música para o Márcio, que a composição é dele, do Lô Borges, e que para mim é uma das canções mais lindas dos últimos tempos.
Before singing, I just wanted to let you know that I was in Brazil with Márcio Borges and Cris Fuscaldo, the two authors of the book who are going to be here next week on September 14th. And it's an amazing book. And I had the joy of playing this song for Márcio, who is the author of the song, with his brother Lou Borges.
Outra coisa que eu lembrei é que a Cris foi a primeira jornalista que falou sobre mim, ainda quando eu tinha feito um disco gravado na minha casa, na Independente, chamado Para Aquelas Perguntas Tortas. Então, foi uma emoção dupla, porque eu pude encontrar com ela também, né, para comemorar esse trabalho, celebrar esse trabalho tão bonito e agradecê-la também pela generosidade dela.
And also, Cris Fuscaldo, who is the journalist, who will be here with Márcio next week, was the first journalist to ever write something about her work. It was her first album, one that she had recorded at home, and somehow Cris, who is a genius, got a hold of it and wrote about it, and so she's still very grateful to Cris as well for that.
Pequenos fragmentos de luz, falar
just need to listen to the radio and have a little book to write the songs. And then I can have like a, you know, I know you have over 20 hit songs at soccer operas. I am modest. I will be content with maybe, you know, 5, 7. No, I don't want it too much. I want to start small. Okay? But I want to ask you this. As a woman, how hard was for you to break into the music industry?
Então, Roberta, ele está falando ótimo, agora ele já sabe o caminho das pedras. É só ir no rádio, pegar um livrinho e botar 20 músicas lá. Mas ele vai começar pequeno. Mas ele aproveita para perguntar como é que você conseguiu chegar lá sendo uma mulher. O fato de você ser uma mulher tornou o caminho mais difícil?
É sempre mais difícil, né? Quando a gente é mulher. E, sobretudo, foi muito complicado, independente disso, né? Porque, como eu disse, eu vim de uma condição muito precária. E ser mulher dá uma potencializada em todos os nossos perrengues, né?
Yeah. So she's saying that, of course, being a woman, usually, as in every other field, makes things a little harder. But it's not only that, it's also the fact that she came from a very precarious background, from a poor family, as she said, and that, you know, connected to the fact that she's a woman, really potentializes the perrengue, which I cannot translate, but potentializes the challenges, basically.
E hoje ainda tem muito isso, assim, tenho que sempre ter um esforço muito maior, gastar muito mais energia para dizer e para mostrar que aquele lugar é meu e eu mereço estar naquele lugar também, porque independente se eu sou homem ou mulher, né?
I still feel like I have to spend twice as much energy to prove people that that place can be mine, that I'm worth it, and in spite of what everybody is expecting as a woman, I can occupy certain positions. So I feel like I'm always spending way more energy trying to convince people of that.
Às vezes eu já cheguei a gravar música com várias pessoas, né? E quando você grava com um homem, por exemplo, a pessoa acha sempre que a canção é daquela pessoa, do cara, não minha. Ou às vezes você vai tocar em algum, vou tocar em algum lugar e sempre pergunto, mas quem vai tocar? Também quando você chega num teatro, tem sempre que pedir quase que pelo amor de Deus para aquela pessoa fazer aquilo que você está pedindo, sabe? Coisas básicas.
Yeah, she plays with a lot of different people, and it's often the case when if she has a man beside her, people keep referring to the man as if he had composed the song, he had written the song, not her. Or sometimes she goes to a theater, and when she arrives, people will say, okay, so hi, lady, who's playing today? And she's like, well, me. So things as basic, as simple as that, are still something that she has to struggle with.
Tem até uma coisa muito engraçada, assim, por exemplo, tem a música de Janeiro a Janeiro, que eu chamei o Nando Reis para participar, gravar junto comigo.
For example, one of my songs, de Janeiro a Janeiro, I invited Nando Reis, who is a Brazilian composer and very famous musician there to sing with me.
E as pessoas, por muito tempo, ainda hoje existem algumas pessoas que acham que a música é uma canção dele.
And for a very long time, actually maybe up to this day, people still think that that's his song, that he wrote the song.
E aconteceu uma coisa muito engraçada recentemente, assim, durante a pandemia, ainda fui dar uma entrevista usando o Skype, né, gravando pelo Skype, e a mulher falava muito sobre o meu pai, coisa que eu não entendia, porque não fazia muito sentido o que ela dizia. E eu comentava, falava que não, e mudava um pouco o assunto, até cheguei a pedir para que ela, de repente, editasse ou se quisesse gravar de novo.
And something very interesting or strange actually happened recently when I was giving an interview and this person, the interviewer, kept asking about my father and repeating information about my father, and I had no idea why she was doing that, and I tried to, you know, start a new conversation and explore other avenues of conversation, but she would keep going back to that topic and I could not understand why, so I even eventually asked her to maybe edit that part of the conversation because I really couldn't understand it.
Então, ela, na terceira vez que eu tinha falado, não tem nada a ver, assim, ela ficou um pouco irritada, olhou para a câmera e disse, enfim, O pai dela fala dela nas entrevistas. Aí eu pensei, meu pai tá dando entrevista, eu não tô sabendo.
So the third time I asked her to stop, she looked a little angry about my reaction and she said something like, well, her dad talks about her in interviews, and she was like, well, is my father giving interviews and I'm not aware of that?
E ela, aí eu fiquei um pouco irritada também.
So I also got a little irritated and angry.
E perguntei pra ela, quem é meu pai?
So I asked her, who is my father?
E ela ficou muito sem graça e disse, o Nando Reis não é seu pai.
And she was very surprised and asked me, isn't Nando Reis your father?
E aí eu até aproveitei para levar essa história, assim, porque além das pessoas acharem que ele é também o compositor da música, ainda acham que ele é meu pai.
So not only they think he wrote the song, they also think he's my father. So yeah, it's a challenge. So now, since you mentioned Nando Reis, actually, and you mentioned Janeiro, Janeiro, maybe should we listen to you? Can you play the Janeiro, Janeiro? Você toca Janeiro, Janeiro? That song, by the way, was in how many soap operas in Brazil? Five, I think?
Sim.
Cinco novelas. This song was played in five different soap operas in Brazil. And for those of you who are not familiar with what a soap opera is in Brazil, it's not really like a soap opera here. It's like more like a series. We were trying to make a comparison and we got to the conclusion. It's like having your song played in Breaking Bad or something as big as that. She had like five Breaking Bads for this one song. And if we consider all of her songs, 20 songs, over 20 songs have been part of soap operas in Brazil.
E essa música é uma das canções que eu fiz, mais antigas que eu já gravei. Ela é de 1999.
And this song I wrote in 1999 is one of the oldest songs I've ever written. Is it true that you wrote it in 20 minutes? É verdade que você escreveu em 20 minutos essa música? Tem um senhor dessa?
É verdade.
Okay. Okay. You ready for that?
Yes.
I want to see Alex writing that in 20 minutes.
Before you sing, I want everybody to take this note. Nando Reis is a very, very old guy. However, he's not her father. But yes, I was dying to hear Janeiro, Janeiro because it's my favorite song. And thank you, Roberta, for playing that one.
E só mais uma coisa. Essa música, ela é uma daquelas canções onde eu escrevi coisas que eu gostaria de viver. E eu acho que por isso ela ia assim. Com muita sinceridade e força também. E eu acredito que por isso as pessoas se identificam tanto com a canção, que ela fala de amor num todo.
This is one of those songs that she mentioned before, as songs that she wrote about things she wanted to leave, but she was not leaving yet. And that's why she thinks that so many people really find that this song is really close to their hearts, because it's similar to experiences that we all have, and desires and wishes and expectations that we all have.
Deixa no ar as várias fases. How do you deal with that? What is this one thing that makes you keep going, looking ahead and not give up?
A gente acabou de passar por uma pandemia, todos nós na vida enfrentamos muitas dificuldades. Você tem alguma coisa que é o que você tem assim, como um guia que faz você seguir em frente e não desistir?
A música.
A música.
Eu, na pandemia, eu acho que como todo mundo, assim, eu acho não, né? Como todo mundo, fiquei muito desnorteada também ali nos primeiros 4 meses. E depois eu pensei, o que eu vou fazer, né? E lembrei que todas as vezes que eu estava em apuros, eu ativava o meu super poder, assim, e me agarrava à música. Então, eu fui compor.
Like everyone else in the beginning of the pandemic, those first 4 months or so, I felt completely lost, and I had no idea what I was going to do to escape that. And then I suddenly realized that I had this superpower, music, so I decided to start writing songs.
E comecei a estudar espanhol também.
And I started studying Spanish as well.
Com o intuito de expandir mais, assim, em termos de fazer parcerias e comunicar com as pessoas e também compor em espanhol.
Wow, with the objective of expansion, not only of my knowledge, but of compositions as well, so that I could play and write songs with other partners as well, or write songs in Spanish as well.
Hoje eu tenho mais de 20 canções em espanhol e fiz bastante parcerias. É, inclusive, depois de amanhã, né, tem um show no SOBs e tem um parceiro meu que vai cantar comigo, que é o Segui.
So, and now I have more than 20 songs written in Spanish, and I started really doing lots of songs in partnership with other people, and actually two days, on September 7th, in my concert at SOBs, one of those partners is going to be there with me, playing songs with me as well.
Sim, vamos cantar a nossa primeira composição, que inclusive a gente gravou. É, eu fiz parcerias com compositores da Espanha, da República Dominicana, como eu sei, do México, da Argentina, da Guatemala, Paraguai.
I have partnerships with writers from Dominican Republic, which is this person saying who's going to play with her on September 7th at SOBs, and they're going to play the very first partnership, the very first song that they wrote together. And it's one that they recorded, but she also wrote songs with people from Guatemala, from Uruguay, where else?
Argentina,
and many other,
Peru,
and many other places.
E comecei também a expandir mais aqui no Brasil, entrar em contato com outros compositores e compor com eles também, como o Carlinhos Brown, o Dadi Carvalho, que é um super parceiro da Marisa Monte, o Sérgio Brito, que é do Titãs, Danilo Caymmi.
So I started writing songs too with other partners in Brazil, like Danilo Caymmi, Carlinhos Brown, Zé Duncan, who else?
Dadi Carvalho,
who is a partner of Marisa Montes as well, and was actually one of the Novos Baianos. So it's many other partners.
And so much.
Yeah, it's a lot of people. And Roberta, can you tell us a little bit how different it is to write songs in partnership, since we have a Mineira audience, so many people from Minas Gerais? I know that we were joking before that you're not only Brazilian, but you're Mineira. Sometimes it feels like before being Brazilian. I actually was listening to a bunch of Roberta's interviews in preparation for this, and in one of those, it feels like she's writing a thesis on pão de queijo, or on cheese bread. It's crazy. She started talking about the crust and how it has to be, and the dough, and the kind of ingredients. It's something that is very, it's one of the staples of comida mineira, of the food from Minas Gerais, her home state. But one of the partnerships that she also did, and a very close one, is Nando Reis was a similar case as that, was with Pato Fu, which is also a very famous Brazilian rock band. So can you tell us how different it is to write a song on your own and write a song with partners? Is the process any different? Do you do like the song and they do the lyrics or vice versa? Or do you do everything together? Qual é a diferença de fazer a canção sozinha ou fazer a música acompanhada de outras pessoas com parceiros? Eu citei o caso do Papo Fum, que é uma situação também, de certa forma,
que remete à sua, sua menina também.
É bem diferente, porque quando você faz a música em parceria, é, assim, quando eu mando uma ideia, por exemplo, a música sempre vem no, com um caminho que eu nunca daria para ela.
Uau,
isso é muito mágico.
It's very different. When I'm doing songs in partnership with someone, it feels like magic sometimes, because sometimes the person gives me an idea that I would never have had alone.
Por exemplo, com o Danilo Caymmi, eu abordei ele, né? Chamei ele para a gente compor juntos, ele aceitou, passou o WhatsApp e tal. E eu pensava que ele fazia letra. Mandei uma melodia. Aí ele...
So with Danilo Caymmi, something like that happened. We started talking via WhatsApp, and I thought he would write lyrics, right? So I wrote him a melody, the song, and I sent it to him.
Daí ele falou, nossa, que lindo, tá? Mas eu não faço letra.
And then he said, wow, that's so beautiful, but I don't write lyrics.
E eu pensei, não posso perder essa oportunidade.
So I thought, I can't miss this opportunity.
Aí fiquei pensando, se ele não faz a letra, eu acho que vou começar a criar a melodia com um pedaço de letra.
So I thought, well, since he doesn't write lyrics, I'm just going to start writing the melody with some pieces of lyrics so that I can convince him to work with me.
Assim ele me devolvia a melodia, o resto da melodia, aí a melodia já estava pronta e eu terminava a letra.
So he would send me back the rest of the song and I would just finish the lyrics.
Assim a gente fez 10 músicas.
So we did 10 songs out of that process.
E eu tenho certeza que a gente ter se encontrado, se juntado, né, nossa arte se comunicar dessa forma fez com que as canções fossem para um outro lugar.
And I'm sure that us having met and our art has having communicated in this particular way has made our compositions, our songs go to another place, do something else that they wouldn't do if we were doing them alone.
Eu achei muito interessante porque eu normalmente faço muita coisa sozinha. Com a pandemia, eu vou dizer que isso cresceu assim 10%. Eu fazia 90 e... Não. 7%. Eu fazia 90 e quase 100%. Tinha 2% ali que eu dividia as minhas composições, porque sempre foi uma coisa muito solitária para mim. E foi muito rico, porque acontece isso, né? A música vai para outro lugar e eu aprendo muito com a forma do outro compor também.
And during the pandemic, I've always written my songs very much by myself, on my own, alone. But during the pandemic, it achieved another height. Like, I would say 10%, maybe 7%. What I mean by that is that maybe I do partnerships in maybe 2% of my songs, but all the rest, I write them alone.
E é muito rico para mim. E hoje eu tenho várias... Na pandemia, eu fiz mais de 200 músicas.
During the pandemic, I wrote more than 200 songs.
Me curei.
And I'm cured. So what do you want to play now? Maybe Abrigo?
E essa música tem uma história interessante que eu tinha até contado para eles mais cedo, que eu sempre fui muito fã da banda Pato Fu e queria muito vê-los gravando uma música minha.
And this song has a very interesting story. I've always been a big fan of Pato Fu, this Brazilian rock band, and I've always dreamed about having them recording one of my songs.
Eu corri num estúdio e gravei um estúdio de uma escola de música lá, e um rapaz gravou numa fita cassete para mim. Eram 5 canções para enviar para a banda.
So I ran and I found this little studio inside a music school and I asked them to record it to me and they tape recorded 5 songs so that I could send the songs to the band.
Só que antes de mandar a fita, eu mandei uma carta pro pessoal do Pato Fu para ver se eu podia enviar as canções, se eles estavam abertos a recebê-las.
But before sending the songs, I sent them a letter asking if they would be okay, like if I sent the songs, if they would be open and welcoming that.
E quando foi um dia, eu recebi uma cartinha escrita à mão pela Fernanda Takai e fiquei muito, muito, muito feliz e nunca mandei nada.
not sending any of my songs.
Só que esse caminho da música assim é tão bonito que a gente acaba se cruzando. E em 2014, o Patufu fiz junto com o baixista e o guitarrista, o John e o Ricardo, uma canção que entrou no disco deles. E depois eu vim a fazer em 2015, entrou no meu disco Todo Com a Minha Sorte, que concorreu ao Grammy Latino, a música Abrigo, que também entrou na novela das oito, minha primeira, das nove, né? Minha primeira novela desse horário.
But life is so crazy and takes you to so many amazing paths that in 2014 I ended up writing a song with John and Ricardo, who are the other two members of Patufu. So we wrote this song Abrigo together. They recorded it first as Patufu. And then I recorded it, and the album in which I recorded it was the album that was nominated for a Latin Grammy. And it also became the first song to be in a 9 p.m. soap opera. The 9 p.m. is like really prime time. This is like Breaking Bad on Astro. So let's hear Amigo.
So,
tão só, é bom porque sinto falta de você. Concordo com a solidão, eu afirmo todo amor. Aqui eu pensasse o contrário. Corpo tão só, sei que nunca vou me acostumar. Dispenso novas emoções, me atrapalho, desconfio dos efeitos dessa ausência.
I don't think we we should overwhelm her because, again, sorry for reminding you all, September 7th, 2 days from now, SOBs, she's going to be playing there a full, entire, long concert. She's been with us for an hour. Do you think we should continue asking questions or one more song? Maybe one more song. Thank you. I really appreciate your honesty and how much you appreciated our role here asking good questions.
Okay, I know you guys want her to play one, two, three. You know, keep her here, as I said. But me and Roberta Campos have a surprise for you guys. So as she said, she has a concert. I hope to see all you guys there at Sounds of Brazil, September 7th, that's a Thursday. And what we're going to do is this, okay? We're not going to take everybody here there, but guys, you have the Instagram from the consulate. You know the account, right? So what I'm going to ask you guys is, on the post for this talk, make a comment. Write the name of the song that you like, or, you know, say Roberta Campos. If you make a comment on that one, and you write, I want to see Roberta Campos. After that, we're going to make a draw and we'll take some of your guys to see her show on Thursday. Okay?
I'm doing it right now. Thank you so much.
Do it now.
So what are we going to hear? What do you want to hear?
Essa foi uma minha primeira música como tema de abertura de uma novela. Então, assim, as pessoas me ouviram por, sei lá, 6 meses, de segunda a sábado.
So this was the first song that was actually the theme song of one of the many soap operas she has written songs for. And so people would hear this song every day, a lot every day, Monday through Saturday, every night in Brazil.
Quero ver só você de novo aqui pra despertar. Tudo aquilo que senti, guardei por nós nesse lugar. Você é um pedaço de mim. Eu quero viver em teus braços pra sempre. Pra sempre.
Consulado do Brasil in Nova York. You've been an amazing partner of ours here. It's always a joy to bring your events here. So you all, I strongly recommend that you follow them, keep tuned to their events. It's always amazing. Follow us, the Clecos. We have many great things going on. Also thankful to the Graduate Center for having us here. Roberta's concert, September 7th, SOB's Sounds of Brazil, in case you're wondering. And yeah, that's it, right? Anyone else we need to thank? You, of course. Thank you all so much for being here, Alex. Thank you for being this amazing partner. And I wish to see you all back. Roberta, you are really a gem. You're amazing. Thank you so much for sharing with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.